Hi there, this is Tech Devotee. I have Wipro 7 watt smart LED bulb with me. In this quick video, we will learn on how to do setup using Wipro smart home app and also alternative solution or workaround if it fails configuration. I have plugged in the bulb and switched it on in usual way. Before configuring the smart bulb, we need to turn on the bulb in blinking mode, and it can be done by turning off and on the switch continuously 3 times as you see here. Anyways, all these details are there in user manual. Here you go. Light is blinking rapidly and we are ready to configure. I just followed user manual and installed the Wipro Smart Home app from Google Play Store. Continued with steps as in user manual. Ensure to use the latest version of this app as previous version was problematic and it gives error message saying failed to add at the end. New version of Wipro Smart Home app works and device gets added as you see here. If you still face any issue with Wipro app, you can use Syska home app, which is little fast in setup as well as in operations. Just to try, I have installed Syska home app from Play Store as you see here and tried to configure Wipro bulb as in Wipro's user manual but with Syska app. To my surprise, it worked like a charm and I am able to use Wipro smart bulb with its all functionalities. No issue found with any of its operations and performance. It also works in similar way if you use Smart Life app available on Play Store. Smart lighting solutions can be useful when you are away from home, especially during long vacations, and still want to turn on and off lights at specific time instead of turning on the light till you return the home. It is needless to say that for any smart lighting solutions to work, power supply and Wi-Fi should be up and running at home all the time. Amazon link to this smart bulb is added in the video description and you can have a look if you are interested in basic level smart home idea. You can also consider other brands like Syska or Halonix smart LED lights as better alternatives as its native apps look similar in appearance and operations. That's all I had it in this video. Thanks for watching. If you have found this video informative, please share it with your circles and do not forget to hit like button. If you are interested in videos like this, please subscribe to my channel and hit bell icon so that you'll get notifications when I upload new videos.